People might think that studying physics and chemistry puts you in a lab, but instead, I'm setting up new companies and helping new products get developed. My name is Dr. Erin Raymond, and I'm the Executive Director for Industry Engagement at QUT. And I have the coolest job because I get to make the world a better place. I began my studies with a Bachelor of Biotechnology Innovation, which was a degree that combined lots of biology and chemistry with business subjects. Then I did a PhD, designing a smart band-aid for older people. I published several papers in my PhD, filed a patent on the technology, and this was licensed to a small spin-out company. Like many medical technologies, it unfortunately didn't make it onto the shelf, but gave me lots of experience on what to do and what not to do when designing new medical treatments. Then I went to the UK to do research in a Centre for Biological Engineering. When I started, I was the only biologist in a large team of engineers. And as a biologist, I like to ask lots of questions about why things happen in a particular way. An exciting part of my job is talking with researchers about their results and how we can apply them in different situations. We get to think about different applications, about different products, different companies, and really try and tailor it to the particular piece of research and what we might identify as an industry need. So a problem that industry are having that they're looking to solve that our research might be able to help with. For example, one of the interesting projects that I've been a part of recently takes gene editing out of the lab into the field. It's totally bananas. Something that's a mystery to us is how to cultivate bananas that are free from disease. In Australia, bananas are consumed by 96% of Australian households. Annually, the cultivation of bananas contributes $1.3 billion to the national economy. So they're important. However, they are particularly susceptible to diseases such as fusarium wilt, also referred to as Panama disease. Biologists have tracked the cause to a soil-inhabiting fungus species called fusarium, particularly tropical rice borer. So the fungus blocks the plant's vascular system, preventing movement of water and nutrients. The plant starves and eventually wilts and dies. As this happens, the fungus produces many more fungal spores that can then spread the disease. In the lab, we know that we can make bananas that are resistant to fusarium wilt through a genetically modified process. We've been growing these bananas in the Northern Territory for several years. They must go through a lot of testing, similar to new medicines, before being available for people to buy and eat. What we don't know is if we can make the same varieties of bananas through gene editing on a large scale for commercial production. Genetic engineering through traditional GM processes inserts DNA into the genome of an organism by using bacteria to transfer it into the plant cell. Gene editing is a new process using something called CRISPR-Cas9. This tool allows you to quickly and efficiently tweak or edit a genome in pretty much anything. Think of it like a tiny pair of scissors that can cut out or replace something small, or more recently, edit one genetic base at a time. We're on the cutting edge and we have all these new technologies and tools around gene editing. What we need are people in different STEM fields working together to test, experiment, and push the envelope of innovation so that eventually we run field trials with these new varieties of fruits and vegetables. We need to keep asking questions and researching what is possible. My hope for the future is that we continue to develop all of these amazing new technologies. I mean, there's such fantastic research out there. What we really need to do is we need to get it out of universities and into the hands of people who will really make it useful and accessible to people all around the world. To do this kind of work, generally, we need a science background at high school, then following your passion into STEM subjects at university. For me, that was biotechnology. Then you can develop research skills through a PhD. In my undergraduate degree, I mixed science subjects with business. I was always interested in how to get something out as a product, and I was just fascinated by all of the amazing research and ideas. With the business and intellectual property skills that I've learned, I can then work between these two different areas and really see things from different perspectives and different angles to get the best solution. And this helps me really try and make a difference. I really find inspiration in getting people together that come from different backgrounds, different languages, different cultures, collaborating, and really brainstorming to get things done. When you get people that have come from such a variety of different experiences, particularly different life experiences, men and women, young and old, we are able to solve problems, we're able to do it faster, we're able to get better outcomes, and it's just really important to the innovation process. There are many opportunities for us to change the destiny of where we're going right now. And I would say to anyone who's feeling a bit anxious around that, studying STEM subjects is a really great way to help try and influence and create that future. The ultimate question for me is how to make sure that we can create a sustainable future, healthy communities, and really use technology to improve outcomes for people around the world.